Hi, I'm Janos, VP of Measurement at Funnel, and welcome to part 3 of 4 of this mini-series on marketing measurement. So far, we covered both MMM and data-driven MTA, and now we are going to get into the next one, incrementality testing. Incrementality testing and GeoLift tests are essential techniques in marketing analytics used to measure the true and causal impact of marketing activities. These methods help validate results from marketing mix models and multi-touch attribution and can be integrated into MMMs for calibration. Incrementality testing measures the additional causal impact of marketing activity beyond what would have occurred without it. And GeoLift testing is a specific form of incrementality testing using geographical regions to compare the performance of treated versus controlled areas. So how does incrementality testing work? Incrementality testing starts with control and treatment groups. You split your audience into two groups, one that is exposed to the marketing activity and one that is not. You then compare the performance, for example, sales and conversions, of the two groups to determine the additional impact of the marketing activity. And then analyze by using statistical methods to ensure the difference in performance is statistically significant and attributable to the marketing activity. And how does GeoLift testing work? GeoLift testing starts with selecting a region, so geographically distinct regions that are similar in terms of demographics and market conditions. Then we apply the marketing activity in the treatment region while keeping the control regions unchanged. Afterwards, we compare the performance between the treatment and the control region. And finally, we use statistical methods to isolate the impact of the marketing activity from other external factors. So why is GeoLift testing that important? Well, you get validation of marketing mix models and multi-touch attribution models. GeoLift tests provides empirical evidence to validate the results obtained from MMMs and MTAs. By comparing regions with and without marketing activities, marketeers can confirm whether the modeled impacts are accurate. You also get calibration of marketing mix models. The results from GeoLift tests can be integrated into MMMs to improve the accuracy and robustness. This calibration helps refine the model and make better predictions about marketing effectiveness. There are 3 main benefits from incrementality and GeoLift tests. The first one is understanding the true and causal impact of marketing. These tests help to quantify the actual contribution of marketing activities, eliminating the noise from other influencing factors, therefore being the gold standard to prove causal impact of marketing activities on sales. Second, it is a good basis for optimization. Gaining insights from these tests guide marketers in optimizing their strategies by focusing on activities that truly drive causal impact and incremental value. This then helps to optimize resource allocation. The insights help in better allocating of marketing budgets by identifying high-impact activities and channels. But of course, nothing is perfect, and there are challenges as well, such as risk, opportunity cost, and time. Not exposing the control group to a marketing campaign or activity that is assumed to be effective comes at the potential risk of losing sales and profits in that control group. Also, to arrive at potentially statistically significant results means the test might have to run for many weeks. Tests are also not suitable for day-to-day reporting and optimization purposes, but rather used for monthly or quarterly validation of measurement insights or testing new channels and activities. And it is challenging to test across different channels since not all channels and activities are easily testable. For example, campaigns on national TV or nationally distributed print magazines, which can also pose a challenge. When working with incrementality and GeoLift testing, here are some practical considerations to keep in mind. Well, first of all, and as always, data quality. Ensure accurate and comprehensive data collection for both control and treatment groups. Then the samples need to be representative. Choose control and treatment groups or regions that are representative and comparable. And then regular testing. Conduct incrementality and GeoLift tests regularly to validate and refine marketing strategies. Incrementality and GeoLift tests are vital tools for measuring the true impact of marketing activities. They provide empirical validation for MMMs and MTA and help calibrate these models for better accuracy. By using these tests, marketers can optimize their strategies, allocate resources more effectively, and ensure their marketing efforts drive real, incremental value. Regular testing and integration with MMMs lead to continuous improvement and more effective marketing outcomes. If you like this video, subscribe so you don't miss the final part where I teach you about triangulation. And in the meantime, check out our other videos where you learn more about digital marketing, marketing data and analytics, and data visualization tips and tricks. All the great content you need to shortcut your way to being a better marketer.